Good morning, Morgan, and good morning to any of Morgan's friends that are joining us for today's video. And in this today's video, we're going to be talking about the DictWriter object in the CSV module, which is like how the DictRead object or class was a modification of the read class. This one is a enhanced version of the write class. Okay? And again, it's specific to handling with the headers and things like that. Anyway, with that, let's get the reading started.
Create an object which operates like a regular writer but maps dictionaries onto output rows. The field names parameter is a sequence of keys that identify the order in which values in the dictionary pass to the write row. Method are written to file F. The optional restval parameter specifies the value to be written if the dictionary is missing a key in field names. If the dictionary passed to the write row, method contains a key not found in field names, the optional extras action parameter indicates what action to take. If it is set to raise, the default value, a value error is raised. If it is set to ignore, extra values in the dictionary are ignored. Any other optional or keyword arguments are passed to the underlying writer instance.
Okay, so what this means is you're gonna need to define your headers or column headers correctly, okay? Or data disappears, or you get crappy data, okay? Or it just doesn't work at all, okay? All right, we'll talk more about this when we look at the example.
Note that unlike the DictWriter class, the field names parameter of the DictWriter class is not optional. If the argument passed to field names is an iterator, it will be coerced to a list.
Okay, that doesn't sound good. All right, now here's the example that the book gives us. And you can look at it if you want and study it. But in the meantime, we're going to go over and we're going to look at the sample code that we looked at the other day when we looked for the DictWriter class, because there's also a DictReader class embedded in the Writer class. And we're going to go look at that right now. And with that, let's go run over and look at some code. All right. All right. All right. Well, here we are in the sample code that I've created for this video. Okay. And what you need to know about this DictWriter class is that you if you're reading in a file, okay, you have to embed it in a reader class, okay? So here we are. This all looks familiar. We open up and we read our input CSV file. Okay. And then we go ahead and inside of that, then we have this like, okay, for every row or record in the CSV file, we want to do this. Okay. So what do? We open up the output file, and then we go W, so we're going to write over the file. If we do rewrite, then we're just adding to the end of it, I think. I could be wrong about that. And here's where the fields come in, with right here, this parameter right here that they talked about. And you got to have it, okay? And then we go ahead and we print those headers before we start going through the rows ourselves, okay? So now we're writing rows to the output, and I've got this print statement in here so you can kind of get an idea for what's going on. All right. And with that, we're going to go ahead to the output and we're going to look at it a little bit. All right. All right. Let's do this. And here we are in the output. There's like 12,000 records or rows in this object. Okay. And here we have, look, there's the row ID. There's what's in the row ID. Date, aircraft model number, see that? And then this is that little thing about where I wanted to print the whole row, okay? Anyway, that's what the output looks like. Of course, eventually, wouldn't it be nice if we maybe filtered out some of the rows we didn't like? And we'll get into that later on in this series. And with that, that completes today's video. Go out, have fun. Try not to get into too much trouble. And we'll see you in the next video. Hasta la vista.